Hi, it's Marie-Pierre. I will show you now, together with my colleague Soren, how to use cortical.io's Retina API to extract keywords. The keywords are selected by their meaning and the importance of their meaning within the text, not by using statistical word counts. This makes the method very powerful and efficient. Let's go to our interactive API documentation on api.cortical.io, click on text function, and select the keyword function, which is the most important feature. We need to copy a plain text in the body field. I selected already an article about Albert Einstein, which I paste here. And let's try it out. So very quickly, you get the list of 10 keywords, which are obviously related to Einstein. So then we used
Yes, in this case, we use the associative retina, which I think is a good fit for this task.
Perfect. So let's close this function and have a look at the other ones, the text function.
Mm-hmm. The text function is a basic text-to-fingerprint conversion method. And again, we just copy in the plain text and we get a presentation back, this position. You can use this for example, building a database of fingerprints for text and then query the database using a fingerprint for a term to get semantically related mm-hmm. results. So this is a semantic search.
Okay, very good. The tokenized function now. So then, can you say a few words about this?
Yes, the tokenized function is a helper function to let you see how the system reads the terms of the text.
Mm-hmm.
It will basically return a list of sentences, where each sentence is a composite-rated list of terms. And we can filter the results by post tags. For example, if we only want nouns, yes, we put an N. And if we want this also adjectives, we put JJ. And these definitions of the post tags are all defined there.
Okay.
On our website, you can there's a link. And this is a pantry bank post tag set.
Excellent. Now there is another function here called slices. We can again paste the same text and retrieve slices of this text, which are, this is very important to note, centered around the topics of the text. And it allows them to chunk very huge texts into their subtopics.
Yes, and this is based on the content, as you mentioned. So for a large text, you would not take just one fingerprint for an entire book, but we can divide the representation into small sections like this.
Mm-hmm. So last but not least, the bulk function.
The bulk function is simply a way of putting in multiple requests to the Retina, but in just one API.
Perfect. Thank you, Soren. So next time I will go through the terms API and show you how to identify contexts and get a list of similar terms. Thank you for watching.